welcome to the stage, America's funny man, Mr. Neil Hamburger.
In the audience. Many blacks. How about Mexicans? About Chinese? Oh, any Chinese here tonight, huh? What about Irish? Any Irish? Okay. What about
Danish?
Jews! Any Jews? Oh yeah. All right. What about Germans? Watch out, Jews, you're outnumbered. What about American Indians? Do we have any of those? Yes, we do. And what about Arabs? Any Arabs here tonight, huh? Good to see you, my friends. And what about Scottish? Do we have any Scottish here tonight, huh? Hey, I guess the bartender was right when she told me that this place serves mixed drinks. The guests at Paris Hilton's house party so reluctant to drink the apple-based beverage that she was serving? Well, because they'd overheard someone saying that there was semen inside her. What? What does medical science call a poor soul who has been diagnosed not only with Down syndrome, but with Tourette syndrome as well? Mr. Robin Williams? And what? What does a plate? Do we have any chefs here tonight? Huh? No? Well, then this won't make any sense. We'll do it anyway. What does a plate of asparagus risotto have in common with sex with Robin Williams? Well, both of them make a woman's urine smell peculiar. When a female fan, when a female fan has unprotected sex with Kenny G, what is the most disgusting thing she'll find she has when she wakes up the next morning? A copy of his latest album. God. Ugh. Why? Why did legendary Kiss frontman Gene Simmons add a sombrero to his onstage costume? Complete desperation. Hey, they can't all be singers. But that's my life. Why did Justin Bieber ejaculate onto his hot fudge sundae? Well, because his management said he couldn't ejaculate onto his fans until he turns 18. And why? Why did David Carradine tie a shoestring around his balls? Well, so he'd remember to take out the trash before he hung himself. Yeah, well, you can shut up, asshole, huh? Can you believe the nerve of prick boy over here, pig boy, piglet, swine boy, garbage man, amateur garbage collector, Mr. Asshole, Mr. Cocksucker, vermin, huh? How dare you come to a performance? Of professional entertainers and talk all the way through, huh? With your asinine comments delivered in your stench mouth, huh? Get some Listerine and get the hell out of here. We're trying to have fun. I'm trying to make this a positive night. I'm trying to bring some light into this room, huh? No, folks, I'm sorry. This is a very dark room with very negative vibes. And I try to turn it around, huh? Bring some rainbows and then this prick, huh? This negative comments, a nattering nabob of negativity, huh? Asshole! And you know what? I'm very patient about that. I don't let this get to me. But Tim and Eric aren't. We are traveling with a team of paid assassins. I'm paying for them. And I guarantee you, you'll feel a bullet in the back of your head if you keep that up during their set, huh? Get the hell out of here! We're just trying to have some fun. That's what it's all about. Having a good time. We have a couple more gags. But times are tough. Times are tough, yeah. Times are tough. I went to see an aromatherapist the other day, and she had bad breath. But times are tough, yeah. I used to buy Gillette's Mach 3 razors. Now I buy the store brand and shave three times. No, but friends, times are definitely tough for BP oil. BP oil, yeah. Did you guys hear this? This was in the news. Did you guys hear that BP oil disaster, that horrific disaster, is now officially the largest environmental disaster in the history of the United States? Yeah! Oh, come on, guys. This is serious stuff. Yeah, it surpassed the previous largest environmental disaster in the history of our great nation, which, of course, was the overflowing toilets in Crosby, Stills, and Nash's dressing room. What? What's the worst thing about being gang raped by Crosby, Stills, and Nash? No young. All right. Hey, did you guys hear? Did you guys hear about this new website? Hear about this? Oh. There's a new website, friends. Yeah, there's a new website. This was all over the news. This new website publishes the names and the addresses and the photographs of all the convicted sex offenders within a 5-mile radius of your zip code. Yeah. It's called Match.com. We got some Match.comers here in this crowd, huh? I can tell from some of the beady eyes, the miserable, lonely demeanor. People here that will never be matched up with anyone. Oh! But that's okay, because for those that are friendless, that are miserable and wretched, huh? Impotent, personality-wise, possibly in other ways as well. For all of you, we're selling Neil Hamburger companion dolls tonight. Oh, these are lovable friends that you will treasure forever, as long as you live. We've also got, for the audio crowd, we've got Neil Hamburger CDs. For the old folks, we've got LP albums. And for the modern, the up-and-comers, we've got DDVs. So do stop by and pick up a few items. We got a couple more gags here before we bring out our young headliners. Why? Why was Jim Morrison buried in a coffin that was 10 feet long? Well, to accommodate his dunce cap. No, not good. Why were Janis Joplin's parents so proud of her? Well, because the Los Angeles County coroner informed them that she died a heroin. Yeah. Ugh, how? How do you stop Carlos Santana from molesting your children? Well, you put a guitar in his hands. We have some other jokes. What? What do Bret Michaels and Terry Schiavo have in common? Well, unless they're in comas, they're both completely unlovable. Why did God send Terry Schiavo to hell? For the sin of sloth. Why? Why do gay men... Why do gay men... Why do gay men? Why do these gay men, these men who are so gay, why do these gay men these men, these gay men, sorry. Why do these gay men? Why do these gay men? Why do these gay men? Why do gay men? Why do gay men bring up the subjects of Barbara Streisand, Cher, and Liza Minnelli so often? Well, to remind everyone that there are folks far more deserving of our hatred than homosexuals. On an all-star comedy tour, starring Dane Cook. And Carrot Top. And Dimitri Martin. And Jerry Seinfeld. And Gallagher. Who would deserve the longest standing ovation? Well, the pilot that flew the tour plane into the side of a mountain. What do you call a small group of sad, depressed, dejected, despondent, demoralized, brokenhearted, emotionally and financially bankrupt, black men carrying a coffin down a dusty, windswept road? The Jackson Four. Okay. Thank you very much. Hey, wild crowd. But seriously, folks. Did you guys hear? Did you guys hear that they had to do a second Michael Jackson autopsy? No. Huh? Speak your comments into a man's penis. Get out of here! We're trying to do this show! Did you guys hear that they had to do a second Michael Jackson... Look what he made me do. They had to do a second Michael Jackson autopsy. You will be billed for that. How much is rubbing alcohol for a bottle? 69 cents, huh? That was only 50% tap water. 35 cents, huh? Bring it to the front or you will be thrown out. But did you guys hear that they had to do a second Michael Jackson autopsy? Huh? Yeah, the results from the first one had to be discarded because they were contaminated. Yeah. Apparently, the coroner was wearing only one glove. What was the official restaurant of the 2009 Michael Jackson funeral? Jack in the Box. What do you get when you cross Michael Jackson's life with Farrah Fawcett's death? I don't know, but you better keep it away from your ass. What do you call it when a doctor, a medical physician, turns off the life support system of an elderly man who has been officially classified as an imbecile? Eric Clapton unplugged. Yeah. Why did God give Smash Mouth 3 top 10 singles? Well, it was a clerical error. He meant to give them all syphilis. And in conclusion, folks, before we bring out our rainbow jugglers to fill some time, Tim and Eric are running late. They got real sick at Ruth's Chris Steakhouse. And it may be until after 1 a.m. that they get here, but we hired some local jugglers. So stay in the front here. It's a good act. Good clean act. What do you get when you place a penny, one copper cent, into each of the five asses of the five members of Smash Mouth? Nickelback. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ben Dean.